Hi, I'm Meisa Salaita, and we're here at Georgia Aquarium about to head into the Correll Center for Aquatic Animal Health. It's a state-of-the-art lab and treatment facility that keeps these thousands of animals healthy and thriving. So how do the technicians and veterinarians care for hundreds of different species? Let's check out some of the cutting-edge technology they use to get the job done. We're in the surgical suite at Vet Services with Dr. Alexa Delaune, and we are doing something super exciting. What do we have here?
Today we have a piranha. So we're gonna anesthetize it, make it sleepy, so that we can do an exam. It's preventative care because we can get a good overall sample to make sure we don't see any parasites or any signs of infection.
How important is preventative care?
Preventative medicine allows us to detect problems before they even start.
And that's what we're doing today.
That's what we're doing today. We're gonna add this powder, which is an anesthetic, and we'll have you fill the bag with water,
okay,
squeeze it around, dissolve it, and then pour it around.
Okay. Why are we anesthetizing him?
One, because it's a piranha, so we need to be safe for our handling purposes.
Right.
And two, we're gonna take some samples.
So would piranhas be aggressive and bite you?
It could. We're gonna do a skin scrape, very non-invasive, and then we won't cause any pain.
Okay.
And you can see it's a little wiggly, but I still got a little sample.
Oh, nice. Good job, didn't get bit.
Then we'll take a biopsy of a fin and of the gill. He shouldn't feel it because he's anesthetized.
Okay. And then the last step is the gills, which is closer to the mouth.
Closer to the mouth.
Do you want me to slide his head towards
Sure.
Then I can say I touched a piranha.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh my gosh. Touching a piranha, touching a piranha. Oh, we're doing so good. What a good team we are.
Yeah,
you got it?
Got it, look.
Yay, yay. Good teamwork.
Nicely done. We have all the samples we need, and we'll take this to the lab to look at it under a microscope.
Veterinarians use all kinds of technology for our piranha samples. Alexa's tool of choice is the microscope. This is so cool.
Yeah, we're using the microscope so we can get a look at all the really tiny things that you might not be able to see with your naked eye.
So what are we seeing here?
So we're seeing a thin layer of mucus that we took from the fish's skin surface. And we're basically seeing nothing, but that's a good thing because this fish doesn't have any parasites or inflammation on its skin. Then we'll go to the fin clip.
Oh, wow, it looks like a butterfly wing.
We can go up a little higher power. You can see star-shaped patterns. That's just the fish's skin pigment, totally normal. All right, now we have to look at the gill.
Oh, this is really beautiful too.
Yeah.
What are we seeing?
So those things are little gill filaments. They almost look like perfect little feathers at the end.
Yeah.
And that's a normal gill. So if the animal is sick or something, you might not see those pretty little feathers at the edge. Definitely a good thing.
So cool to see this level of detail. We think the fish looks good?
The fish looks really good.
Wonderful. The equipment and technologies that the veterinarians use depends on the animal, what ails them, and the type of tissues, like bones or vital organs, that are involved. Let's have a closer look at the body and how that's linked to the animal's function. At Georgia Aquarium, many of the animals can't easily be moved. So what do you do when you can't bring the animal to the clinic? You bring the clinic to the animal. Ocean Voyager is one of the world's largest habitats, a busy place for the veterinarians to make a house call. But they do have to do a regular checkup on many of the animals here. Today, it's a cow nose ray.
What we're gonna do today is an ultrasound and take a radiograph or an x-ray. It will give us a look inside of her. It's very non-invasive. It's a really good tool to assess her overall health.
And is that the same type of ultrasound that humans use?
Exactly the same. In fact, the same brand my doctor used on my foot. So it's the same thing, yeah.
So we're gonna flip her over and then we'll do the ultrasound.
So what we'll do is start with the heart.
The ultrasound is a medical imaging tool that uses sound waves to see the inside structures of animals.
You can see that she is contracting her heart right here. So we can calculate her heart rate. These things are her gills, which is pretty cool.
Yeah. How's she looking?
She looks really good. So she is in really good body condition and eating really well. All right, so I think that's good for the ultrasound.
Okay.
We're gonna go ahead and take an x-ray of her.
Okay.
We to take her out of the water for just a minute and put her on a digital x-ray plate. Snap an image and it will pop up on a computer and we can put her right back in while we look at it. All right, so on this laptop, we can see our image popped up. So right here, this black stuff is her gills.
Oh, it looks just like a rib cage.
Yeah.
But I guess she doesn't have bones.
She doesn't have one, no. This ray looks fine. I don't see any fractures at all, and the cartilage is nice and white, just like it should be. So different technologies help us get a good, complete view of all the different systems. It looks totally normal.
This was awesome. Thanks so much for sharing it with me.
No problem.
Working in the water has its own set of challenges, but having mobile equipment is the best way to treat many of these animals. Now it's your turn to figure out exactly how sound and light waves are used in this equipment. In accredited zoos and aquariums, animals have access to the best preventative care and veterinary expertise, something that's rarely the case for animals in the ocean. One interesting case is the California sea lion, like this guy, a really special one. Hi, Andy, it's nice to see you.
Nice to meet you.
Who's this guy here?
Well, Neptune is a rescued California sea lion. He was rescued just last summer along the coast of California. He was deemed non-releasable by the federal government, so we were very happy to give him a forever home here at Georgia Aquarium. He had a pretty tragic story. They found him with fishing hooks in his flippers, and then the veterinarians did a full examination on him.
Using a state-of-the-art CT scan, the vets found something very disturbing inside Neptune's head.
We found out that he actually has bullet fragments in his head. He has them around the jaw and a couple different spots.
Is he okay? Did you have to do surgery?
He is okay. We don't have to do surgery. The vets feel that going inside there, since it's around his head, is going to be a lot more invasive.
So Neptune found his home here, and there are vets here to help take care of him?
Yeah, we have vets on site every day. They're always doing checkups on him, making sure that they're healthy and happy. You can see now he's thriving. He's doing very well. He's looking very handsome. He likes to show off his flippers. He's just getting his voice. He's just learning how to use his voice. And he's an ambassador for his species to teach people about the California sea lion, the threats they're facing in the wild.
Neptune, it was very nice meeting you, and thanks a lot, Andy.
So bye.
Some of the same equipment used with Neptune is also used for humans. It's just adapted by the scientists, technicians, and engineers for the animals. At clinics like this, a little technology can go a long way to keeping the animals healthy, thanks to the power of steam. Remember, keep your eyes open. The wonders of steam are all around you. And until next time, stay curious.